Ranchers and residents along our southern border are fed up with the Border Patrol and its lack of action when it comes to illegals. According to reports, ranchers are saying that the U.S. Border Patrol does not go far enough to protect them from smugglers and others crossing the Mexican border illegally. For more on this story, let's welcome in via Skype Glenn Spencer, president of the American Border Patrol. He joins us from the border of Arizona with the Mexican state of Sonora. In fact, it's not really an exaggeration to say he can see it right out his front door. Glenn, welcome back to Newsmax Prime. It's good to have you.
Great. It's JD, it's good to be here. You're right, I'm looking out the window in Mexico.
Well, mindful of that, you know, I got a good look at the problem down there when I was serving in Congress and then when I ran for the Senate, and people down there had had it up to their earlobes with frustration. Is it possible it's gotten even worse in recent months and years?
Well, they're frustrated, but the story you were reading from there, the ranchers who were complaining, that was part of a meeting of the National Sheriff's Association. We had, I think, close to 100 sheriffs descend on this little community this week. And yes, some ranchers were invited in to tell their stories, including my friend John Ladd. But why were they here? It was interesting. I dug into this. And these sheriffs have come down here because of the drug epidemic that's hitting their communities. And they're wondering why it's coming. They're coming. These drugs are coming across the border. That's why they were down here. And that's why they had the ranchers here, and they all went down to my friend John Ladd's ranch. And, you know, this has come up in the presidential debates, and Carly Fiorina has said this is an epidemic. Millions of people are being affected by these drugs coming across the border. And I find it interesting that they all agree that the border isn't secure, right? They all agree that we have a drug epidemic, but nobody's connected the dots. In other words, if we had a secure border, maybe we would control the drugs.
And yet it seems that there are those who even showed up at the meeting. If I'm not mistaken, Warren Buffett's son was there to get an award. And I hope I understand this correctly. He was making the case for a continuance of open borders. Did I get that right?
No, what he said, which I found interesting, he said we really haven't defined what is a secure border. All right? And he said that. Well, I found that fascinating. He said, we need to define it. Well, excuse me, Mr. Buffett, I've been working on that problem for 10 years, which is one of the reasons we came up and designed this sidearm system that you've talked about before. As a matter of fact, I gave a paper 2 years ago in Dallas, and the question was, what is border security and when will we know when we have it? And I found it fascinating. And here, this billionaire family, the Buffetts, are concerned with measuring border security, which is what I have been dedicated to for 10 years. And then here we have Donald Trump, who wants to secure the border with a fence. And the thought came to my mind, well, wait a minute. You know, Howard Buffett was right here this week. He was back over John Ladd. I talked to him. He was on his ranch. He was here. Now, we'd love to have Donald Trump come down here. Maybe we could get these Buffett billionaires and the Trump billionaires together and come down here together, and I could show Warren Buffett how we could measure border security, and I could show Mr. Trump how this same technology could prove that his fence is working. So I was thinking, you know, can't all these billionaires get together and come down and maybe put their brains together and solve this problem?
Yeah, well, it wouldn't cost them that much for a bus ticket or using one of their charter jets like a school bus in the sky. Glenn, Arizona is one of the early primary states. It's important in this upcoming electoral battle. You've had some contact with campaigns, but has any presidential candidate decided or been to visit you in the intervening time since we last had you on this program?
Well, I don't know if you saw the Washington Post on August 25th, but there was an airplane shown in there flying along the border, and it said, "Go Trump" on the bottom. Well, it explained that I was the pilot. And why did I have that go Trump up there? Was because we were having a demonstration of our technology. We invited all of the presidential candidates, and it was only the Trump campaign that acknowledged our invitation, and they were sending somebody down. So that's why I put go Trump on the bottom of the airplane. But it turns out the fella had to be diverted to the Iowa fair at the last minute. But no, we lost that opportunity, but we did get a lot of publicity for Donald Trump in the Washington Post.
But suffice it to say, with the time we have left on this program, Glenn Spencer, the American Border Patrol, you would welcome the presidential candidates, all of them, Republican, Democrats, Libertarians, Independents, Vegetarians, anybody to come see the border and to come hear what you have to say. 10 seconds.
Absolutely, and you can see in this article, Warren Buffett is saying the same thing I've been saying for 10 years.
Well, I'm glad you cleared that up for me. Glad you cleared that up. Glenn Spencer, as always, we appreciate your time. That'll do it for right now. Back with more after this.